Hello, with this video we will make a public Python package from object-oriented programming OOP classes. By the end of this video, you will learn how to create a Python package locally, how to upload it to Pypi repository, and publish your packages with the world so anybody could use it. I suggest you do not skip any step in this video. I promise a good time with each step separately. Let's check what you will learn in this video. There are three main parts which should be covered sequentially, step after step. The first one, to have your own OOP-based class or some classes which you would use in your project. In few moments, I will show my class that I will use to make a Python package. The second one, when we are having a working Python OOP class working well, we can convert it to Python package locally. That we will do in this part. And the third one, when we are having a working Python package working locally, we can upload it to Pypi repository to make our package be available to everybody. That is the goal of this video. So, the first step is to have defined class and methods working locally. This is my OOP class I will convert to a Python package. This is a very simple class, which includes two methods to calculate body mass index and deliver some conclusions as output. Before all things happens, it is a good time to check locally how this class working. Import BMI calculate. This is my class. I will call it as BMI. The object will be VitalTest, this is my name, and I passing these arguments, age, weight, height, and gender. Now, call calculate BMI method to calculate my index. 27. Good. And what is the conclusions are? You have an overweight. Okay. I see that my class works fine locally. Before going further, we need to be sure that there are no programming errors at this point. It is done on my side. In our example, we can jump to the next step. The second step, make your Python package working locally. At this stage, we are having Python script with our OOP class only. In order to convert this script into some kind of Python package, we need to create additional files, which will tell the system that this class can be installed to our Python environment as a package. We will create a setup.py and init.py files. Okay, here is our Python script with the class and methods. Let's create a structure we have just discussed by using terminal. At first, making a directory named bmi_calculate. That will be the name of our Python package. Here is it. Now create an empty file of setup.py. Here is it. And in bmi_calculate directory, create an empty file of init.py. Here is it. Here is the folder and file tree we are having right now. We need to move our main Python script with class inside the package folder. Please keep in mind that package name must be globally unique, so do not use very common names. Here we go. Let's check the tree again. Yes, now the file and folder structure looks as we expected. Setup.py and init.py files are in correct places. Now is a good time to put some information into files we have just created. Let's begin with setup.py. Here we will use a setup tool to set up parameters for our package. We will specify the name of the package, the version of the package, the description of the package, which Python script will be used in the package, and zip save property. Pip automatically look at this file when we want to install a package. Let's do it real. Open setup.py with any Python interpreter. I am using Sublime Text. we will use a setup tools to define the main information about our package. From setup tools, import setup. In setup, we need to add the following information. Name of the package. Mine is BMI Calculate. The version is 0.1 as it's a very new package. Short description about our package. Calculate body mass index. That's enough for description. Author, it's me. This is my name and surname. Python scripts which will be included in the package. This is BMI Calculate, stands for file name of our Python scripts with defined class and methods. And lastly, zip save property. I will set it as false because it means that the package cannot run directly from a zip file. Yes, fix this bracket. That's looking good so far. And we have a setup.py prepared well. Now, let's discuss what we have to do with init.py file. The init file telling Python that this folder contains a package. A package always need to have an init file, even if the file is completely empty. Here we need to add at least one line. The init file here import the specific class from our package. The reason of this line is we want to be able to import a class directly writing from statement. If I did not include any code in the init file, the package still work, but any program that use the package would have to import classes more indirectly with additional lines of code in program code itself using from statement. This is what we will do in the init file. It is like a shortcut for importing the desired class directly. There is a dot in front of our module. This dot is required if you use a Python 3, but if you are working in Python 2, you should not need it. Okay, in terms of what we have discussed, let's put some information in init.py file. And here I specifying from .bmi calculate import desired class. It is a person for BMI. And that's it. Save it. Init file is also prepared well. Here is its current structure we should have. Not too much file so far. Now, we are ready to install our package locally on our computer. To do that, you need to run simply pip install and dot from main directory of our package. Simple like that. Let's do it on real package. Open the terminal in the main directory. Check that we are on the correct location. We should see setup.py and package folder by side. So, type the command pip install and dot, and we have successfully installed our package on our computer. To be sure that this package is installed and stored among our package, let's check it by pip list command. Let's try to find our package in this list. Here is it, BMI calculate. And the version is 0.1. That is what we expected to see. Now, we made a lot of so far. I hope you are still enjoying. If you are with me, we are almost in finish line. The most exciting part. Now we can to upload our Python package to Pypi repository. You should know that there are two repositories we are interesting. Pypi for testing and regular Pypi repository. Test PyPy and the regular PyPy is not the same. You must create a separate user account for each of these websites. I have created it for myself, so let's go further with our example. First of all, we need to create some more additional files to move forward. This is license.txt, setup.cfg and readme.md. Let's do it for our package. Open again the terminal. Here is a current structure of files we have. Okay, let's create a license.txt, firstly in package folder, then setup.cfg and readme.md. Yes, these three files we need to have to be able to upload our package to PyPy. Now, we need to put some information to these files. Open the package folder. Let's begin with readme.md. Open it with your text editor and write some markdowns information about your package. For example, in headline, I telling that I will provide instruction with this file. The second line is a heading in level 2. It's about how to install the package to your machine. And in the paragraph below, I write some details about the package in main key points. How to install the package, how to use it, and related information. For demonstration purpose, it is enough. Saving it and going to the next file. Now, open setup.cfg. I am using still Sublime Text, and here's it. And here simply write that metadata the package is using is from description file which readme.md, which we prepared just a minute ago. That's all for setup.cfg. Save it and go to the next file. The next file is license.txt. Open it as all files before. And here is the free space for your requirements to users who use your package. Copyrights, rules, conditions, and related information. Let's say our package is open source and no any restrictions are valid to this model, so users can feel free to use it and improve it without any restrictions. And my name and surname. Simply like that. Now, additional files required to be able to upload our package to Pypi repositories are prepared. The second step in here is to build a TAR file that is suitable for uploading. For this, we will use a setup.py file with a sdist command inside Python environment by using a terminal. That is a simple procedure. So, go to our package, open the terminal. Check the file structure we are having right now. So, let's type python setup.py and sdist at the end of line. Press enter. It seems that package tar file is being created. So, let's check the current file structure from terminal right now. Yes, here's our tar file. Perfect. Open the folder. And here's it. Now, we have all the things prepared to upload our package to Pypi repositories. Again, just remind, test.pyp.org is not the same as a regular Pypi repository. Firstly, upload the package to Pypi test repository, and when we are sure that our test is successful, upload our package in regular Pypi repository to share our package with others, so everybody could install the package just by typing pip install and your model name at the end in user terminal. For this, we need to install a small package that helps us to do it. It is Twine library. Install it quickly just by typing pip install Twine. That's it. Check if Twine is among other packages we have. Pip and list. Where's Twine? And yes, we have it. Okay, let's start to upload our package to a test repository. Open the terminal in the main directory. Quickly check the file structure. Seems that everything is fine. And now type a command in terminal. Twine, upload, repository, URL, https, test.pypi.org, legacy, dist, and the start at the end. Write your user credentials for test PyPy repository here and press enter. Looks that the package is being uploaded to test PyPy repository. Let's check it. Go to the test PyPy website with your credentials. And here we go. That is the link to download and install the package to any user computer. Let's copy this command and try to do it now. Come back to the terminal. So paste the command and press enter. Here I see that the package is successfully installed on my machine. Let's check it if it's located among other my Python packages in this list. And here is it. Perfect. Now let's do the same but with a regular PyPy repository. I uninstalled my package before doing it. The folder seems to be in correct places. Open the terminal. Check the file structure one more time. You can see that the TAR file is in this folder. You should see the same in your site. Check it where our terminal is open right now to be sure we are on the main package directory. And write a twine command, very similar as we wrote previously. Twine, upload, dist, and the star at the end. Write your credentials for regular PyPI repository right here. It is uploaded in just few seconds. Our package is not big one. Copy and paste this link, you can look at your package directly in PyPI repository. And here we go. This is our package. And now it is available to anyone in the world. Anyone can download and use your package just by typing PAP install. That's great. Here's my name. Everybody can see that you are the author of this package. So, let's copy and paste PAP install command and try to install it on our computer. Open your terminal again and paste here the PIP command. Yes, it is downloading and finally installing. Let's check one more time if this package is among our in this list. Here is it. BMI calculate and the version is 0.1. Done. Now we can use it. So, try to use it to be sure that everything is working. Open the terminal or a new Python script anywhere in your computer. To make it simply, I launch Python application directly in terminal. Importing my package, BMI calculate as BMI. Create a new object. It is my name VitalTest, with the class person for BMI. And passing some parameters. Age, weight, height, and gender. Let's print my body mass index. It's 27. And what is the conclusions about it? It's overweight. Everything working. I hope that you got a result on your site as well. And that's all that I wanted to show you today. I really hope to provide more videos like this for Python programming tips, MLOps, machine learning engineering, and much more. Subscribe to the channel and never stop learning, and see you on the next video. Bye bye.